Sairam to everybody. Now, we have been thinking of a kind of a subject which I never thought would be so useful. Last week, few children were here, that's all. I was just talking in the form of a dialogue on spiritual topics, which is kept in the website. And we are getting very good feedback, very good replies from everybody. Therefore, if you have any topic of your choice or any questions of your preference that you feel fit enough to be deliberated, I want you to liberally ask those questions. Please, kindly feel free. You'll be helping a lot. Everybody. Yes.
So I'm from the UK.
Okay.
So I want to ask that, as you rightly said, Swami has given us the sacred organization, the Sri Sathya Sai Seva organization worldwide. But how do we bring about harmony and unity in the organization so that with single point of focus we can take Swami's mission forward?
It's a really good question. What is lacking today is harmony or unity. Everywhere, not necessarily in UK, everywhere there is no unity. Why? At all levels, even the highest level, you don't find unity. If we just inquire deeply, we will come to know from Bhagavan himself. He said, why there is no unity? He said in one word, absence of purity. Because there is no purity, there is no unity. When there is no purity, what is there? Impurity. What is impurity? What are the impurities which do not permit unity to prevail? The unity is missing because of absence of unity, absence of purity, because so many impurities that do not permit any unity at all. What are the impurities? One, ego. Ego is the first reason for the absence of unity. The second, position mongering. I want to be president. Why? If you are president, no. Position mongering. This position mongering is non-spiritual. Position mongering is irreligious. Because God has a position in our heart, not the chair. The chair is the position outside. Heart is the position of God. Chair outside will make you chairman. Position, that's not that. Position mongering is one cause for the absence of unity. Second point, ego, position mongering. Third, money factor or financial implications. Because one person is rich, we'll give him extra honor. We give him all posts of office. We give him all the respect. But in a spiritual organization, money has no value at all. In front of devotion and faith. In front of devotion and faith, money has no value. But we are giving importance to money. What do I mean by that? We collect funds. We collect funds. A person who gives more money expects some special treatment, expects from you gratitude, thanks, indebtedness. So this kind of preferential treatment, this sort of leaning towards financial status is another point for absence of unity. 4. Lack of awareness. We have no awareness. What do I mean by that? The awareness that this is a spiritual organization. The awareness that this organization will help me first and then anybody next. It should help me first to win over my ego, my jealousy, my pride, all my weaknesses. I should be able to win over them. I should be able to conquer them. So this organization is for the betterment of the person first, of the self first. That awareness is not there. If we talk to people, they go on saying, Swami said, Swami said. Or everyone quotes Swami. But I tell them, thank you for quoting Swami, but it applies to you first. It applies to you first. It begins with you first. Anybody next? Therefore, lack of awareness that it is to help me first, it is to evolve me first, and anything next. Absence of unity is because of another respect, unhealthy competition. For example, in UK, there are so many groups. What's your good name? Your name?
Oh, my name is Seelan.
Seelan.
Yes.
We have Seelan group, we have Satish group, we have Anil Kumar group, but there is no Sai group. There are different groups in UK. Papat group, Sai Mahima group, Siddhu group. These are all groups of individuals. As in Sonia Gandhi group, Sharat Pawar group, Congress I, Congress O, Congress Yes. I don't know. So we have groups in the name of individuals. But people have forgotten that there is only one group, such a Sai group. Somebody said, Anil Kumar, to which you belong to? I tell them, none of these groups. I belong to Sai group. I have no Anil Kumar group, sorry. I have no separate group to invite you to join there. I have no group. No. So, and among these groups, there's competition. One function is held recently in UK by Shami group. There's one gentleman by name Shami Talwar, Southall unit, very big way, Shami group. And other groups did not attend. Last year Shami organized in a very big way. I attended. About 25,000 people attended that. 76,000 people watched it. But none of the other groups attended. This year Shami organized again. There is a letter of appreciation from Buckingham Palace. There is a letter of appreciation from the cabinet ministers, but our people boycotted it. See that. And some other official organization is inviting me. I am afraid that the other groups may not attend now. What to do? So people like me are put to unnecessary, inconvenient, embarrassing situation. When the letter comes to you from the official organization and from the international president, you cannot say no. And when you attend, the other groups don't attend the meeting, who are my equally good friends. It's very painful. And there's competition among them. So absence of unity because of competition. So there's no unity because six factors I explained, basing on my close observation. These are all the impurities that lead to disunity or lack of harmony. Am I clear?
Don't you think, sir, that people like yourselves are the catalysts to bring about the unity in certain aspects, like the scenario you just gave?
You're right. For information, I don't know how long you know me. I am known for my frankness. I am known for my fearlessness. I am known for being not crazy for any position. I am also known for not given to flattery or unnecessary praise. With this tongue we praise Swami, and we cannot use that tongue to praise another man. As the Holy Bible says, God is envious. He doesn't want you to praise anybody excepting Him. God is a jealous God. It is written in Bible. Why He doesn't want another second God? God is only one. Further, Holy Bible says, thou shalt not utter the name of thy God in vain. Thou shalt not utter the name of thy God in vain. So I am not here to praise anybody. These are my awkward qualities or good qualities, desirable or undesirable. This is what I am. This is what I am. To be very plain enough, as an answer to your question, I hammer on these points. I don't simply mention, I hammer. The worst thing is, they don't invite me again. Very good. Because I am not on a political campaign seeking their votes or franchise, contesting an election. Better they don't invite me. Very good. Good. I'll go to some other place. If they don't invite me, second place, that is also better. If no one invites me, best for me, because I can do some personal sadhana. So to please others, I don't say anything. I'll be very blunt. Because I want Swami organization first. I want Swami, nobody else. I don't seek anybody's favor. That's what to do. The life is designed like that. I cannot help it. So, wherever I go, I hammer on this unity. In some place, I think it is in Ecuador or some place, there are some people who are not attending Sai Center. At the end of my talk, they hugged each other. They made a pledge that they would attend Sai Center hereafter. In Andhra Pradesh, there is another place by name Anakapalli, near Vizag. I attended that meeting. At the end of the talk, what I did was, I made all of them stand on the dais. Official group, unofficial group, ruling party, opposition party. I made all of them stand on the dais. I was visiting number of places there, and everywhere they give me a shawl. I don't have any shop to sell them out, and I don't need all those shawls also. So I got a collection of many shawls everywhere they were giving me. So I started giving them shawls to everybody, and brought number of garlands. I wanted everyone to garland each other. There is no rival group there in today in Anakapalli. They want me to visit their place now. So I don't mind to go down to any level. To touch their feet also, I am ready. Because for Baba's sake. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are those that are persecuted on my name. For they shall inherit the kingdom of heaven. Really, Bible is such a beautiful book. It touches our heart straight away. Blessed are those that suffer for me. Blessed are those that are persecuted for my sake. For they shall inherit the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whether that kingdom of heaven I would get in or not, I do not know. But I am ready to touch the feet anybody, to compromise to any extent, to establish unity among them, because I have given my life of 42 years or so for the organization. I don't stand for any prestige, only compromise. Long back, when I was the state president, there are two rival groups who started fighting in front of me. They said, come on, sir, let us have the meeting. They thought it is a political meeting. I have not gone there to supply sticks to them to fight. I said, you can fight, please give me some time. I'll give you lot of time to fight later. Just give me some time because I have come all the way, see. I am speaking in front of Baba's picture. I know that. It is at a place long back by name Hira Mandalam in Srikakulam district. District meeting. The rival groups are ready to fight. I spoke for 1 hour. I said, now it is time to solve our differences. Please ask questions. You reply. You ask questions. They will reply. I wanted the rival groups to discuss at the common table. Please believe me, no question from anybody. They shook hands and unity established. So my business is to establish unity. In UK also I am ready to work in that direction. I don't keep quiet. If they want to fight after leave, very good. We'll supply bombs to them also. And we have got some terrorist groups in India. They will also suggest how to fight better than their usual way. But I will see to it that I meet those groups and work towards unity. I got phone calls already, and one phone call says, don't come. I said, it is the very reason why I come. Yes. When you say don't come, it means to me, welcome. well, come. So I will also work in that direction. Thank you for raising the point. Thank you. Shield, good. Any more, please? This is a serious issue, you know, bothering everybody. Yes, sir. I don't mention the name of the country. They invited me. I said I would come. I gave them dates also. There was no follow-up action. Nobody wrote letters. And many devotees are there. They asked me, when are you coming? When are you? I said, as and when you want me. But no follow-up. Later I have come to know that there are political groups there. So the whole trip had to be suspended. I don't say cancelled, suspended. Baba may decide some other day, who knows. And one near Nepal, abadi, they said, Mr. Anil Kumar, we want a letter from the international level. We are awaiting permissions, please. I said, thank you, please wait for permission. But Yamadharma Raja does not wait for you and wait for me. Yamadharma Raja meaning God of death. He won't wait for permission. He has got his own timetable. He will ask you, follow me. Now let me get from permission from national president or international. No, no, no. Because he will shift you to other planet. For interplanetary travel, you don't need permissions. I said, thank you very much. Please wait for permission. Anything, sir? You are from?
I'm from Germany.
You don't have these problems?
Somebody may come and tell you, there some building is coming up here. Swami is not here. Swami has gone there. We want funds, let's go. So this caution, not to speak of Indians, though it is a rude expression, it meant positively thinking to prevent you from being exploited, because people may exploit you. But that's not the way they should put it. They should have told you, be careful with those who might exploit. Never allow yourself to be exploited. Be careful. They can put you in a decent way. Rather tell you, don't spoil, talk to Indians. Indians are not untouchables. And you are not an untouchable either. And Swami says, one caste of humanity. He did not say, one caste of humanity accepting the following. He did not say that. So that's what I mean. Any question? That's wrong to say that. They can question it.
I understand what you are saying, but what it was is when we go to bhajans many times, we go up and have an ice cream and just sit down and talk, and then we walk home. It's an outing for the girls a little bit. And so that's what it was. And certainly, it would not have given the appearance that these young ladies were out to exploit us. We were just having a little relaxing time before they have to go back home.
The girls have nothing to exploit. There is no need to exploit. It's not like that. I mean, there may be other agencies. Something I say, Swami left Gudavarti, he is there in some other village. We are constructing some school. We are constructing some mandir.
Right.
Or somebody may come and say, Premasa is already born. We are constructing a So that's it, right?
I think this, they know the rule, they don't really know the spirit of the rule. And if they just see people being friendly and loving with each other, they construe it as, they see the rule, and that's all. And so that's
lack of application.
It was, right, it just was a lack of understanding.
They don't understand. Supposing, silence, good. When fellow is about to die because of pain, he shouts. You cannot say, silence. Talk after you die. Silence is general rule, but there is an exception.
Precisely.
That's right. One thing is common sense.
I have a question. What's a nice experience in the Buddha Tantra Tour? For me, I know a little bit and get out. So that some people really, as Swami is present with this whole love, and the darshan hall is full of love. And we sit maybe close to another woman, and she had problems with me. And so I live a little bit, and then she starts to take handkerchief, and then I see she had black medallions. It makes this a risk against me some movement. So and
on the floor?
What?
Movement on the floor.
Yes, I seem to get sneezed then because she gets nervous, and so I move a little bit more, and so it's not the first experience. The reason is that some people have, they're sitting there, they're a woman, they are not come for 3 weeks, they stay over 1 year or longer. And though they have, sometimes, I don't know what they do, they have no heart, there is impurity. But so they have problems, maybe I move, or so they take something, material, and make it against you. She's not, I know, so, make it do it against you on the darshan hall. Yes.
Oh.
Yes, really, it's true.
It's really pathetic. Very pathetic. I'm very sorry to hear that. I'm 100% sure that Swami will not approve such things. He will not approve. But be happy that you can leave them and go somewhere else.
Yes, I have to learn to get early, to get up early.
Leave them.
Yeah.
I tell you what I do.
Yeah.
If these two boys don't like me, I say thank you. There are 10 people that like me. If these 10 people don't like me, thank you, 100 people want me there. If you 100 don't want me there, there's some country, the whole country needs me. So it's best way of, and as Baba says, run away from the bad company. Chaja Gurjana Samsarga. Run away from the bad karma. Since we don't run away by their bad actions, we run away from them. We are safe. Am I clear? You understand?
Yes, of course. Inside coming move when I sit it on, so that I have to learn to really to listen.
Run
to
away
them.
From them. Yeah.
Yes.
They are doing great health.
Yes.
Because by being in bad company, you get bad vibrations.
Yes.
Vibrations. Why? Thank you. Words.
Yes.
It reminded me, we were talking about the Bible, and Jesus said in the Bible, if you enter a city and they don't want you there, you leave and you shake the dust off your feet.
When they want me, you thank you. I'll go some other place. I don't want to fight with you. It's not worth it.
Bye.